Yo, welcome back to the channel, boys and girls. Today we are doing a first look and a quick review on the Pro Stealth saddle. So let's get started. Oh, and I hope you guys like my outfit because I am officially a brand ambassador for my favorite cycling brand ever, Montan Sports. And also I forgot to mention is I'm rocking the S-Works Evade helmet. This thing is super aero from what I heard, but it is extremely hot. I'm sweating buckets right through my scalp over here. It's crazy.
So what is the Pro Stealth saddle? Well, it follows the trend that we've been seeing in the last few years of these sort of shorter length, more aggressive and race focused saddles. We've been seeing this from companies like Specialized with their Power saddle, as well as Bontrager with their Aeolus saddle, which is what I currently run on my Specialized LA Sprint. Now, the reason why I wanted to try out this particular saddle is actually for two reasons. One is after speaking with all of my clubmates and my teammates who run the saddle, they absolutely love it to the point that they fitted this saddle on all of their other bikes as well. And the second reason I want to try out the saddle is because this is the entry level version, which retails for about $130 to about $140 USD. However, I actually bought this saddle on the secondhand market through Facebook Marketplace for only $80. So I figure for 80 bucks, if it doesn't work out, I can always sell it and get my money back, no problems. So about this particular saddle. So this is the 142 millimeter width version of this. This is 142 millimeters at the widest point. And the weight on it is only 203 grams, which in my opinion is pretty light considering it's not trying to be a weight weenie saddle by any means. And it actually weighs about 20 grams less than my Bontrager Aeolus saddle. Now, this is the entry level version. You could spend a lot more money, probably almost double version. This version, you get the steel rails, you get some sort of carbon polymer material for the base, but the higher end versions come with carbon rails as well as a full carbon base. So the idea with these sort of shorter nose saddles is it's supposed to allow you to comfortably maintain a more race or more aggressive position on the bike while fully supporting your sit bones here at the widest point. And by having this large cutout here in the center of the saddle, it acts as sort of a pressure relief channel in order to alleviate any discomfort from, you know, your area down there, your nuts, your balls, and your taint.
Bruh.
So the plan is, guys, is we're going to put this on my Yo-Yo R6 frame, which means that I'm gonna have to remove my Bontrager Mantra saddle. We're gonna take it out on the road, and afterwards, guys, I will give you guys my thoughts on the saddle. So let's continue. All right, guys, now before I swap out the new saddle, I forgot to mention that it's extremely important to have your bike fit dialed down. And it's also important to know your measurements of your current saddle, whether you measure that distance from the nose of the saddle to the steer tube or to the center of your handlebars. And the reason why that's important is because this new saddle, the Pro Stealth saddle, it's actually 15 millimeters shorter than my existing Montrose Elite saddle. I believe the Montrose saddle is 265 millimeters, and the new one here, the Pro Stealth, is 250 millimeters in length. So keep all that in mind when you are swapping out a shorter saddle for your existing one. And also too, as far as the angle or the tilt of the saddle, I prefer a more neutral sort of position, meaning that the front half or the nose of the saddle, I like to have that be as level as possible. All right, guys, and this is what it looks like with the new saddle installed on our Yo-Yo R6 frame set. I have to say, just a quick side note, is when you live in a big city such as Chicago, it's almost impossible to have complete silence. You have street traffic, you have people walking by, yelling, you have cicadas, you have all these noises making it almost impossible to get clean audio footage for these videos. But anyway, we have our saddle installed. It's been torqued down using a 5mm Allen key, and it's been torqued down to the recommended spec. In my case, my recommended torque is anywhere between 12 to 13 newton meters. So the next thing now is the guys to get this out on the road, and we'll see how it feels, and then I'll be able to share my thoughts with you guys.
All right, so one of the things I noticed right away was just how comfortable this saddle was right out of the box. Normally it takes a little bit of time for me to kind of get comfortable and acclimated with the saddle, but in this case the saddle was super comfortable. And one thing that we all can acknowledge is that saddles is a very personal thing. And even if someone recommends a saddle to you, it still doesn't necessarily mean it's gonna work out for you. But with all that being said, this saddle is definitely comfortable. I've done about 30 miles on it so far. I've been able to put some power down, be in the drops, be in the hoods, and it is super comfortable. And so for $80 used and $130 brand new, it's definitely worth looking into. And even if it doesn't work out for you, you'll definitely be able to get your money back, as these saddles are super popular. All right, so that about wraps it up for this video today, guys. As always, if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please feel free to leave them down below. And I will check you guys on the next one. Thanks for watching. Peace.